Okay, now we're up here on the top of the office building where we were installing the air handler. We've got our condenser set. We're almost finished running our electrical line over here. Very important, always check your voltage on the machine. 9s and 12s are 115 volt. So we'll run our line, I'll double check it at our box, and then we'll do our install. But what I want to show you real important is because we're above a roof, or if you're doing it on a bracket mount above anything that you want condensate to drain away from, as a heat pump installs, I mean, it actually makes condensate during the winter operation. So that's something you want to keep in mind. On the bottom of the condenser, there are two plugs, two holes. We have one on each. What I'm gonna do is pick the right hole for my application, and then I'm gonna install a plug in one, and then I'm gonna install a drain tube in the other. So for my particular application, I'm gonna install my drain tube right in the very back, and it just snaps right in, rubber seal around it, and then my plug will actually go into my other hole. And then it just pushes right up, tight seal. Also, for the sake of time today, we're not going to put it in a pan just to get it done, but we'll also put an auxiliary pan up under this machine, and that way, for safety purposes, we'll catch any condensate that's not caught by that drain. So anytime you're above a ceiling, and by code, most of the time they recommend a secondary pan. If it's outside on a bracket, it really doesn't matter. But above a ceiling, put a pan in, run auxiliary drain out. So anyway, we're gonna start our install. We'll put it up on two blocks, make our connections, and finish our wiring. Okay, for the sake of light, I'm gonna show you how to make the wire connections very quickly. Basically what we do is we run our high voltage in one side and run our control voltage in on the other. If we were outside in an outdoor environment, of course we'd want to put this in conduit, not a Romex. But our high voltage, basically we're going to take our neutral wire and take it to in on our incoming power side from our disconnect, and we'll put it up under in and secure that connection. We have our ground on our grounding lug at the bottom. Our hot wire, which is our black, we're going to take it to L from our disconnect. Okay. Okay. Now we have our outdoor sensor wire. If for some reason you can't find this wire inside your machine, just pull your top off and just take a look, because more than likely it bounced around and it's not sitting right here. So basically all you do is you take it and you just snap it right in. And then just take it, tuck it out of your way for time being. Now we've got all your leads from your indoor unit to your outdoor unit. And basically you straighten up all your wires so they'll go in there nice and neatly. And you want to go back to your manual to your little piece of paper where you wrote down which one you put on which one. Make sure they correspond, that's very important. So on number one, we used blue. So we'll take blue. And put it up under one. Then we'll take orange. And put it up under number two. Number three, we're going to use yellow. And like I say, all of this matches what I did on the indoor unit. Your color codes might change. They might be different. Just make sure the same exact wire, no matter what the color, inside is the same outside. And then L1, we have black. L2, In one, we have red. In brown, we have ground. Okay, now there's all our wires. Now we got that done. We would just want to make sure we put them up under the designated connection areas so that wire stays good and tight and secure. And that's all it is to it. You'll notice you have two L's and two N's. One set of L's on the far right are going to be the ones for the high voltage from disconnect in, and the other set from the far left to right is going to be your entry wires from your air handler to condenser connections. Okay, it's very important to remember that if you cross any of these wires during installation, you can actually burn the control board on the indoor unit. Also, before any startup is done, you want to check your voltage at your disconnect and make sure the voltage is what is applied on your label on the side of the machine, as this machine's 9,000 of 115 volt. If there is a mistake and you put 220 on it, you just lost the machine. So anyway, just double check that before you do any startup, and that's the most important part of the wiring on this segment. In this section, we're going to talk about how to tighten these lines. These are pre-flared line set that we're using today. And basically what we're going to do is we're just going to put them on here. We have a metric Newton meter torque wrench that we're using. And each torque is set per the installation instructions per the unit. So this one today, I'll show you how to do it. We're just going to put it on there. I've got a number 17, tells you which direction to go. I got my wrench set to the manufacturer's instructions, and we're just going to tighten it up. And you heard it click, it's tight. You don't want to over tighten these fittings. If you do, it will squeeze the copper and you'll have a leak from that day forward. These machines are great machines, but installed improperly, tightened with the wrong wrenches, will cause you nothing but a headache from this day forward. So we want to make sure this step is completely followed through. If you don't have a torque wrench, it's not very expensive. We use a set made by CPS. I don't think it's no more than $100 and a half, somewhere in there. But I'll show you how we do the large fitting. Hear it click, that's tight enough. And you always want to use a backup wrench. If you don't, you can ruin this fitting here. So use a backup wrench, put your torques on it, and you should be in good shape. We'll do the exact same thing at the air handler down below. In this application, it's very dark, so we can't get a good camera angle. So we'll show you here. Basically, we do this. Now, next step, we're going to hook our nitrogen to this machine, pressurize it, leak test our joints here and at our air handler to double check, make sure we don't have any leaks, and then we'll go into the vacuuming step. Okay, here we're going to pressurize the machine with nitrogen and double check for leaks. So I'm going to pull the cap off that comes with the machine, install our 410A adapter. Make sure it's good and snug. Sometimes the valve core don't depress all the way because of a new adapter, or either an old adapter, one of the two. But just make sure it's good and snug. That way you pressurize it and able to read pressures throughout your gauge. All right, so now that's hooked up. This is open. I'm gonna go ahead and cut on my nitrogen tank. Open. All right, and we're gonna start introducing nitrogen into the system. And we're going to pressurize it to 200 pounds of PSI. All right, we have our system pressurized with dry nitrogen. It's been sitting now for about 10 minutes at 200 psi. It hasn't moved at all. And then we took soap bubbles and we just sprayed around every connection and ensured we don't have any leaks. So we did this here and at the air handler, and also made sure it held nitrogen. So now what we're going to do is turn our tank off, disconnect any connection, and we will blow out the nitrogen in the system. Okay, now we're going to start the vacuuming procedure of our machine. We're going to cut our light on. Got our gauges set on 410A. We have our vacuum pump hooked up, center line to the center of the manifold, out of our manifold, off our high side port, to our 410A adapter, onto our machine. So basically now what we're going to do is cut on our pump and make sure our manifold is open on the high side. And now we're going to start to pump down into a vacuum. What we want to do is pump this down into a vacuum until it hits 500 microns. Once it hits 500 microns, we know it's in a true deep vacuum. We'll cut the pump off. Okay, we've been pulling the system down into a vacuum for a couple hours now. We've got the microns way down below 500. It's 329. I mean, we know we're good. So what we're going to do is go ahead and shut everything off. Get ready to open our freon lines, dump the gas into the air handler. All right, now we're at the stage of releasing the freon into the indoor air handler and double checking all of our steps and finalizing the installation. So next step is we want to ensure that we have proper voltage on the machine. So before I release the freon and power it up, I want to just double check my voltage. And I'm checking it at my disconnect, which I got 121.9. Voltage double check. Put my disconnect back together. And we're ready to release the gas. Very important step here and things you need to remember is that everything on these systems are metric, even the Allen keys. So if you don't have the right Allen key, don't use it. If they round off, then you got a machine with a rounded off service valve. So it's very important that your key is very tight and it's a metric. On this particular machine here, you're running a 5. So a 5 goes on the suction line and we're releasing the gas and you back it off completely all the way. All the way back. And the discharge line is a 5. Okay, and all the way back, and that's it. They're not real hard to turn back, so if it feels like it's hard, double check your wrenches and make sure they're 100% right. I have seen people round them off before and it really destroys the system. So proper tools and proper technique ensures you have a proper install and a good long lasting system. Only thing left to do here is we have to power it up. We put the disconnect in the disconnect holder, shut the lid. Few more things I want to do to the system. I want to take some foam. I want to cover this line completely to keep it from dripping. I'm going to do the same thing at the air handler and around the hole I made in the air handler. I want to seal that with insulation and make sure there's no intruding air from the back side of the air handler. Other than that, on our next segment, we'll show you how to start up the air handler and show you the features of ductless air. Now we have the installation complete on the Ductless Air 9000 unit. We have the registration card we have to fill out. It basically gives you all the details of the registration card on it, and some of the most important ones. You need to read the card before you get started. Make sure before you even start you have all the proper tools. It's got a place for license number and all that. For warranty purposes, this must be filled out. So I'm gonna fill it out right now and send it in. Far as the machine, after running it, it has a pretty cool option on it for its fan speed. Basically, the fan speed has several different operations. We can put it on mode button and operate the fan here. So basically, one of the neat features of this machine is we have 3D airflow, which allows us to operate the swing. We mash swing on the remote. Now the swing is automatically up and down. Then we have a neutral swing, which is basically the bottom of the swing up and down. Then we have fixed swing, so we can stop it wherever we want and just blow the air in that direction. And on the 3D airflow, we have a side-to-side control. So if we want it to go to the right, it'll go to the right just by mashing airflow. And it will do that until we mash airflow again. And now it's constantly changing right to left, right to left. So it makes sure it covers your whole room with 3D airflow, which is one of the neat features of this machine. Not all machines have it. Very few do. And that's it. And you can hear it, it's so quiet you can barely even hear it running.